So here we go with the lecture number 32 and the finite volume series, and as we recall, we are just looking at the deferred correction approach using two different methods. One is the downwind weighting factor method, which we have discussed, and we have seen the shortcomings of that method when from a multidimensional system to one dimensional system. When we go, we can easily or could easily see what is the problem with that approach, and there could be some remedies. And now what we are going to discuss in this particular lecture is the NWF, which is the normalized weighting factor. So that is what we are going to talk on in this lecture. Now we have seen that if issues with the DWF, now we will similarly formulate the NWF, and here in this case the one would try to, so this one actually try to address some of the issues of DWF method, so that we can have a better platform or framework. So it operates by linearizing the normalized interpolation profile such that phi f tilde would be looking like L phi c tilde plus k. So that is a sort of a linearization, and L and k, these are all constant that represents the slope. L represents the slope, k represents the intercept of the linear function within any interval of phi f with the number of interval depending on the HR scheme which is being used. So this is an exact representation for nearly an all HR scheme that we have already discussed earlier. Now for example, in normalized variable formulation for mean mode scheme, if you look at that, the values of L and K that we have obtained there is like this, 3/2 0 for range where phi tilde goes from half to 0, then half half where phi c actually goes between half, and then 1 0 which is L square. So these are the values of L and K which we have already derived while looking at the HR scheme. Now second step is to rewrite this ratio phi f minus phi u divided by phi d minus phi u. That ratio one can write L multiplied by this factor and then plus k. So that is what one can do, which can be transformed to a system where one can write the phase value phi f equals to L into phi c minus phi u plus k into phi d minus phi u plus phi u, which is L phi c plus k phi d plus 1 minus L minus k phi u. So where phi c is the cell concerned, phi d is the downstream node, phi u is the upstream node, along the flow direction. So, this will be the flow direction. So, that is how the representation of the nodes which are being used, and this is pretty much consistent throughout our lectures what we have been following with the notation system. Now, L and K, these are the values L and K for a number of higher order scheme, and this is the values for a number of HR scheme. So, which we can see for different kind of scheme, what are the values. So, let us say this is again in uniform grid with NVF formulation, then what one can see for upwind L and K, this will have values like 1 and 0. Now, second order upwind which will have L and K is 3 by 2, 0. Central difference scheme, these values would be half, half. From, so this would be 1 1/4. Now, when you look at quick, the value would be 3 by 4, 3 by 8. Now, we have already seen for mean mode, the value has a different segment. One is 3 by 2, 0, it could have half, half, it could be 1, 0. This is the range where phi c less than half, greater than 0, phi c less than 1, greater than half, and elsewhere. So, similarly for Usher, the LF value, LK value will have three segment. One is 3 by 2, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. Here the phi c goes between 0, phi c tilde goes between 1 to 2 by 3, this is elsewhere. Marshall scheme, it will have a segment of 4. So, 2 0 1 1/4 0 1 1 0. This is phi c when lies between 0 to 1/4. When 1/4 to 3/4, 3/4 to 1, elsewhere. And similarly, the smart scheme, where this will also have segment of 4, 4, 0, which will get you 0, 3 by 4 by 3 by 8, 0, 1, 1, 0. This is 1 by 6 to 5 by 6, 5 by 6 to 1, this is elsewhere. So, one can see that different L by K value can be obtained on a uniform. Now, for unstructured grid, this upstream node or U is virtual, so the term involving phi U is treated as a treated in deferred correction fashion, but the resulting source term, which would be for unstructured, the resulting source term, which will be in form of 1 minus L minus K phi U, is smaller than 1 would be obtained with the standard deferred corrections. So, that is what it would give in your unstructured system. So, the NWF requires less under relaxation than the standard deferred correction method. So, obviously, if you require less correction, NWF requires less under relaxation, which will lead to faster convergence. So, if you have that, now we will start from our equation which we are dealing with, this phi f. So, the phi f that we are having is L phi c minus phi u plus k phi d minus phi u, which is finally written as L phi c k phi d 1 minus L minus k phi u. So, we start with that. For a general case multidimensional grid, m dot f phi f can be written as m dot f 0 L f plus phi c plus k plus phi f, then 1 minus L f plus minus k plus phi u plus minus m dot f 0 L f minus phi f plus k f minus phi c 1 minus L f minus k f minus phi u minus. So, this plus and minus goes in the, so if you linearized, rise, then you get flux f f m dot f k f plus minus m dot f l f minus flux c f m dot f l f plus minus m dot f k f minus and flux v f m dot f 0 1 minus l f plus k f plus phi u plus minus m dot f 0 1 f l f minus k f minus phi u minus. Then once you substitute all these things, the discretized equation is obtained as AC phi C plus F NBC A phi F equals to BC. So, system looks similar, but the differences would come in the coefficients, like here it would be flux FF, which is KF plus M dot F 0 minus LF minus M dot F 0 AC, which is flux CF NBC LF plus M dot F 0 minus M dot F 0 and your BC is QC VC minus summation of these fluxes, flux BF, which is going to be QC BC NBC 1 minus LF plus minus KF plus phi u plus multiplied with m dot f 0 minus minus 1 minus LF minus KF minus phi u minus minus m dot f 0. So, this is the term which is due to deferred correction, or the source term due to deferred corrections. So, that is how in your NWF formulation the discretized variable would look like, and they would appear in the discretized system. Now, this one was initially developed. There is a small thing which is associated with this one. This was initially developed for unstructured grid, and with this formulation which allows a full implicit treatment of the HR scheme. But what is happening, the full implicitness of the method on unstructured grid of phi u, which is being an actual node in the computational domain, that can be resolved in the algebraic equation. So, that has now a larger stencil that includes the far nodes EE and WW. Now, for the one dimensional system like what we have done for the 1D system C, E, W, EE, WW. For 1D system, this again we can simplify this particular set of multidimensional formulation to 1D, 1D NWF formulation, and there it will be AC still phi C plus F goes from E west E WW AF phi F equals to BC. So, where your AE would become flux FE, which is M dot E KE plus minus M dot E LE minus plus M dot W 1 minus LW plus KW plus. Similarly, the AW is flux FW, which is MW0 multiplied with KW plus minus MW0 multiplied with LW minus plus M dot E0 multiplied with 1 minus LE plus KE plus. A EE, which is going to give you the flux FE, which is minus M dot E 1 minus LE minus KE, and A WW flux FWW, which is minus M dot W 1 minus LW minus KW. So, AC is summation of NBC flux CF, which is M dot E 0 LE plus M dot W 0 LW plus minus M dot E 0 KE minus M dot W 0 KW minus. So, that is nothing but your minus AE plus AW plus AEE AWW plus M dot E plus M dot W. So, that is what you get. Now, what that does, this NWF formulation, that HR schemes L is greater than that of K. So, provided there is a narrow region of NVD close to the downward line, and that we will see how it happens. The second thing is that the value of AC is always positive, and that is why. So, AC is always positive, and that makes the system is a stable system, or the instability does not arise. Now, along the downwind line of NVD, where your, so downwind line NVD variable diagram, my L and K, it should be 0, 1, a value of 0 for AC coefficient is obtained. So, in this case the L and K can be set to capital S 1 minus L phi f, where L is usually set to the value of L from the previous interval of the scheme. So, what it brings down to, the moral of the thing is that NWF to be much more robust than the DWF scheme, because it always guarantees this coefficient AC to be positive, which does not lead to any instability. Now, the previous derivation was based on the NVF formulation. Now, we look at this NWF method in the TBD framework. So now we want to see, so what happens that except that muscle Van Leer limiter, all the limiters of the TBD scheme actually will be presented along a straight line in the TBD, CBC or psi r diagram. So, and one can write that psi rf is a m rf plus n, because all of them except muscle Van Leer limiter, all other limiters will follow some sort of a straight line there. Now, m and n, these are constant, one is the m is the slope, n is the intercept of the linear function and depend on their geometric equations within an interval of psi rf. Now, the number of intervals, it depends on the high resolution TBD scheme. Now, for example, let us see what happens to this particular equation if you equate with the mean mode scheme. So, for mean mode scheme, the value of m and n would be 10, 01 or 00, because in this range rf is less than 1, greater than 0, rf is greater than equals to 1, rf is less than 0. Now, once we use this psi rf definition and then we try to evaluate the phase value like phi f equals to phi c plus half of m rf plus n phi d minus phi c. One can do little bit of algebra here, which would be half of m phi c minus phi u divided by phi d minus phi c plus n and phi d minus phi c, which will again lead to 1 plus half m minus half n phi c plus half n phi d minus half m phi u. So, again phi u, phi c, phi d, it will follow the flow direction. So, the values of m and n one can find out all that for the different schemes, and also, so the one thing that you can obtain like this particular expression when you has the same form as earlier expression, like if you write in this form phi f equals to l phi c plus k phi d 1 minus l minus k phi u. So, if you compare these two, what one can write is that l plus l equals to 1 plus half m minus n by 2 and k equals to n by 2. This is what it gives you back. So, once you look at the similarity. Now, for different schemes, what are the values of this. So, again this would be on uniform grid and what you get uniform grid the psi r diagram, then the upwind scheme that has m and n equals to 0 and 0, second order upwind scheme which has 1 0, central difference scheme has m n equals to 0 1, from has m n equals to half, then you can have quick which has the m and n 1 by 4, 3 by 4, downwind scheme which has values 0, 2. Then you can have the other like Osher, where the MN has 3 segment, one is 1 0, 0 2, 0 0, which is RF less than 2 greater than 0, RF greater than equals to 2, RF less than 0. Now, muscles, the MN has 4 different segment, 2 0, half half, 0 2, 0 0, where RF goes between 1/3, 0, RF goes 1/3, 3, RF greater than equals to 3, RF less than 0. And super B, which is given as in again 5 segment, 1 is 2 0, 0 1, 1 0, 0 2, 0 0, where RF less than half greater than 0, RF less than 1 greater than half, RF less than 2 greater than equals to 1, RF greater than equals to 2, RF less than equals to 0. So this approach is similar to your NVF, NWF, so there is an approach which is similar to that NVF, NWF can be implementation of the similar TBD based NWF. So one can implement in the similar fashion. So that actually talks about different class of higher order, high resolution schemes and their improvement, and then looking at the corrections. Now the point comes when use these things finally in the convection term, because we are in the framework of convection diffusion system, the boundary condition becomes then important element. Now the boundary condition for the convection terms are generally much simpler than for the diffusion term. Why? Because the typically the boundary condition which you encounter are inlet, where some velocity would be given, outlet wall where no slip boundary condition would be given, that means then symmetry. Now, typical boundary elements which one can see now here in this particular unstructured element, this is an unstructured elements, you can see the boundary elements. So, this side is the boundary side. So, this particular, this is the boundary, and all these elements are exposed to this, or rather this face which are exposed to the boundary face. So, these, all these elements are exposed to the boundary face. Now, you have the discrete values of phi which are stored at the cell centers. Now, but one has to calculate this SB denotes the boundary vector, surface vector, B is the boundary face. Now, this C is the centroid of the boundary elements, and so this face B which is actually exposed to the boundary. So, an SB which is the surface vector pointing outward. So, the discretization of this particular cell would now become, for any dimensional system, in a generic system, it will become F NBC J C dot S F equals to 0. So, C stand, J C stands for convective flux only. So, the interior faces are also discretized using the similar expression, but they are independent. So, any interior faces are also can be discretized using the same expression, but they are free from these boundary elements. Now, here one face is exposed to the boundary. So, this flux which is shown here, it has to be properly represented for this boundary. Now, when you talk about that particular flux at boundary B, one can write this would be the convective flux or the component of the flux, this is rho v phi at this boundary faces. So, such that this J B C dot S B, which will become rho v phi B dot S B, and one can say at this face it is the flux m dot phi b. Now, if you implement this in this discretized system, so this will become now surface integration of rho v phi dot S at faces plus rho v phi dot S at B equals to 0, where F refers to the, maybe one can say this is F 1. So, F 1 refers to the all interior faces. For this particular element C, this one and this one are the interior faces, and the fifth face is the boundary face. Now, the specification of the boundary condition involves either you specify the value or unknown boundary value phi b, or one can specify the boundary flux. So, depending on that, this particular discretization equation or discretized equation needs to be modified. If the boundary value is known, that is what we call it is a Dirichlet kind of boundary condition, and that we have already seen how to implement that kind of boundary condition. So, if the surface flux is provided, then that is known as Neumann conditions or the gradient conditions. Now, that is the formulation at any inlet boundary. Now, we will look at the inlet boundary conditions. So, inlet boundary conditions. So, this is for convection flux. So, that is the boundary face, and the inlet through this face goes in this direction. The normal is this direction, this is the surface vector, and the connection between C and B is this line along EB, and this is perpendicular to that. So, this already we have considered that slightly the centroid is slightly off. So, here in this domain you can say that phi is either specified, since the inlet boundary condition for convection it is dependent on the velocity field. So, most of the time the velocity field is known. So, which means if the velocity is known, that leads to that the flux is also known. If you know the velocity, then you can also say the flux is known. Now, once you look at the discretized equation, this would be F 1 N B C rho V dot S F 1 equals to minus rho V dot S B phi B, which is minus m dot b phi b. Now, in any high resolution scheme is used to discretize the convection flux at the interior spaces. I mean, assuming that one has used the HR scheme for the interior faces, then is implemented via deferred corrections approach, then the modified algebraic equation for the boundary element could be written as A C phi C plus F goes over the element equals to B C. So, that means my AF is flux FF, which is minus F dot 0, AC is summation over all the faces of flux CF, which is going over all the faces m dot f 0. Now, one can write minus capital F NBC A plus F m dot f, and then BC equals to minus flux Vf, which is m dot b phi b minus f n b c m dot b minus phi f h r minus phi f upwinds. So, this is my term due to deferred corrections, where f refers to the interior neighboring nodes of the C, and here one can say this could be also F1, then that makes life simpler what we are doing. This F1 is the interior faces of boundary element. So, the now that is how you implement the, now if you go to outlet boundary condition. So, that is an outlet. So, outlet, the flow goes in the outward toward that, and this is the cell C. So, outlet, no information from the downstream of the boundary grid point is available. So, that means if this is the boundary face, then you do not have any information from this side. Everything whatever is interior, one has to use that to get this. Now, because of this directional phenomena, the phi value at the boundary is highly dependent on the upstream location, because at the outlet the flow has to go outward. So, everything will be heavily dependent on the information available at the upstream locations. So, in fact, the upwind and the second order upwind scheme, for example, it does not do not require any information at the outlet, since all its value can be expressed as a function of the value at upstream. So, if you look at pure first order upstream and second order upstream, they use all the information from the points which are sitting ahead of it. It does not require anything at the downstream information, but the treatment that has to be proven to be very effective at the outlet boundary condition is to assume that phi profile is either fully developed, which is equivalent to that del phi dot n at the boundary should be 0. That means no gradient at the boundary. Usual practice at the outlet is to apply the upwind scheme, where phi d phi b should be equals to phi c. Now, similarly, you discretize the convective flux for the interior elements. We are using, these are interior elements. If you use for high resolution scheme, then the modified algebraic equation for the boundary element would be using some deferred corrections. So, the equation will look a c phi c plus f n b c a f phi f equals to b c. Now, here again the a f would be flux f f, which is minus m dot f 0, a c is f 1 n b c, because f 1 only, so this is the face which we are interested, because that is the boundary face. Now, f 1 a c will get information for all the interior faces, these are the, so this is all are belongs to interior face. For example, this is f 1 prime, f 1 double, f1 triple, f1 fourth. So, four interior faces are there where these fluxes need to be calculated, which will become capital F NBC A plus F1 goes NBC M dot A plus M dot B, and BC, which can be represented at F1 NBC flux BF, which is minus F1 NBC M dot F phi up HR minus phi F upwind, which is again the boundary condition, boundary value for the deferred corrections. Here also F1 refers all the interior faces of the boundary element, and C is the element which is concerned or the owner, and F is all other elements or the neighboring elements, and the boundary, it says the gradient is 0. And then, so we have looked at the inlet, we have looked at the outlet. Now, the other one which we can see is the wall boundary condition. So, the wall boundary condition, which is essentially at the solid wall, typically fluid flow problem, it is a no shape wall, which means the this is the surface which is the wall. So, it is a wall boundary condition. Again, this is the cell C, interior cell, and this is the wall. So, wall boundary condition, actually no slip boundary condition, says velocity components would be 0, at the wall would be 0. That means, whatever velocity component, if it is a multidimensional system, you have u, v, w, they would be 0. So, as such, convection flux, that means this will lead to convection flux to be 0, and that does not appear in the algebraic equation. Now, again, similarly, if you are using for any interior nodes the high resolution scheme or HR scheme, then when you come down to boundary, you need some corrections, and or rather to adopt a high resolution scheme at boundary, need to have deferred correction approach. Okay. So, the modified algebraic equation for the boundary element, this C, which will look like a C phi C plus A goes over NBC AF phi F equals to BC. So, the coefficients, they would be now can be evaluated, where AF equals to flux F F, which is minus M dot F 0. AC, which is summation over F1, F1 means all other interior faces. So, this could be F1 1, F1 2, F1 3, F1 4. So, there are four interior faces which can be used for this calculation. which is summation over f1 goes, which is m dot f 0. So, if you rearrange that, so you get back the summation over neighboring cells with AF plus F1 goes over the interior faces M dot F, and the right hand side term would be minus F1 goes over all these faces VF, which is F1 NBC M dot F phi F HR minus phi F upwind, which is again the term arises due to deferred corrections. And F1 here, which also refers to the all the faces, belongs to the interior faces, and C is the cell which is concerned or the owner cell, and F are all neighboring cells. Now, there could be one more condition which you can look at is the symmetry boundary condition. In symmetry boundary condition, which means the if this boundary is a symmetry boundary of a element, nothing crosses across this boundary. So, no flow across that boundary. So, whatever is here, it should be exactly similar to that side. So, it is treated in a similar fashion to the wall boundary condition, where the flux, convection flux normal to the symmetry boundary said to be 0. So, three different kind of boundary conditions we have looked at it in respect to the higher order discretization. So, when we started with the convection discretization, we had looked at all this inlet boundary, outlet boundary, symmetry boundary, wall boundary conditions, but that was with respect to our initial discretization scheme. Now, what we have looked at here is that for interior node, we are using the higher order schemes or higher resolution scheme. So, obviously, when you come down to boundary, you do not have the information from the other side. If this is the boundary, you do not have the information from this side. So, to apply the HR scheme, you require some sort of an modification to that, which is a deferred corrections and which will come as a source term in the discretized equation. So, with that objective, like the application of HR scheme to be consistent with your all interior discretization, we looked at the different boundary conditions. So, the first one we looked at inlet, where you come across all these coefficients and you can see the corrections which arise due to the deferred corrections. Similarly, you come to outlet where no flow crosses the boundary and final equations or the source term will have a some deferred corrections. So, that allows you to, and the third one at the wall boundary where the no slip boundary condition is satisfied, which means the convection flux is 0, also come across this deferred corrections. So, you can be consistent in application of the HR scheme at interior node and the boundary node, and that concludes the discussion on the HR scheme. So, we'll stop here and the next class we'll take it up from there. Thank you.